As you wave your Bible, may your life be waved in the prophetic, in the supernatural, in Jesus' mighty name. I have one question for you. What compels you to thank God? In your everyday life, what makes you to go on your knees and say, thank you, Lord? My people, faith is a lifestyle. Christianity is a relationship. If we say faith is a lifestyle, we mean that no matter what life throws at you, you need to soldier on. You need to press forward. As Apostle Paul had once said, for what is happening now shouldn't tell of who we are. Am I communicating? What you are going through should not tell of who we are, but rather it should expose of who our God is inside our lives. And I want to give a testimony over what I'm saying. Failing to clap hands for God. I'm giving a testimony. It's a clear indication that people cease laughing in God to clap hands for. Because life seems to be in the opposite direction of where they are going. That's why I asked this question. Why gives you the strength to clap hands for God? To thank you, God. We only thank you, God, when changes are positively taking course in our lives. That is when one can say, oh my God, I serve a living God. When there's nothing at all, when the eyes of men does not see what God has done in his life, they can never appreciate God. My people, let me tell you, the evil spirit is divine. In other words, it is invincible. Divine and mean in their kingdom. Am I communicating? It is good, it is pure in their kingdom. And what is released as authentic? What is released as genuine can never fail to leave an impact in anything that it comes across. Satan believes in destruction. In his kingdom, destruction is authentic, it's genuine, it's fine. What am I saying? In every breath that he takes, there is a weapon that he releases. And if we Christians are going to behave the whole way, the opposing people are behaving, that is always on our feet, acting in praising and worshiping God, we will, at the end of the day, see no existence, no power and authority in the name of Jesus. Why? Because we seek and watch if anything will happen. In other words, we are part-time Christians. And a part-time Christian can never spend a full-time até o fogo.
Aí ganha, a gente vai rolar para o outro.
Imagine. If we wish, God, you don't say thank you, God. And you put a mask on, you don't say thank you, God. And then let me tell you, what would be the fifth step is where the devil has mounted a trap for you. And if you are waiting for fame to say thank you, God, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Father, in this big one, you'll be taken down. Where is the prophet? Where is his anointed mentors? Where is that?